Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Today, in this second video lecture of second week for the course Applied Mathematics 1, we are going to learn about matrix operations. Matrix operation means that how to add two matrices, how to subtract two matrices, how to multiply two matrices, and how to multiply a scalar with a matrix. In the previous lecture, I have already told you about the overall contents and objective of this course. So I would like to tell you to specify the objective of this lecture, that students will enable to learn about the arithmetic of matrices, matrix operations, and to apply these operations for different properties of matrices like transpose of matrix, symmetric or skew symmetric matrix. Now, what are the matrix operations? Matrix operations mean, what are equal matrices, how we can add and when we can add two matrices, how to subtract two matrices, how to multiply two matrices, how to multiply a scalar with a matrix. These are the matrix operations. So the first definition is about equal matrices. Two matrices will be equal if they have the same dimensions. Order of the matrices are equal and the corresponding entries are equal. For two equal matrices, there are two conditions. The order of the matrices will be equal and the corresponding entries will be equal. For example, these two matrices are equal. In these two matrices, we know that the order of these two matrices also equal and the corresponding element are equal. This matrix has order 2 by 2 and this matrix also has order 2 by 2. So the order of these two matrices are equal and the corresponding elements also equal. So these two matrices are equal matrices. Equal matrices can be used to solve for variables. For example, these two matrices are equal. Since these two matrices are equal, so we can compare these two matrices and we can compare the corresponding elements of these two matrices. So by comparing, we can find the unknown variable in these matrices. In these matrices, we can find the unknown variable by comparing. For example, the value of A will be equal to minus 1, the value of C will be 2, the value of D will be 4, and the value of B will be 1. The value of D will be 4 and the value of B will be 1. Since these two matrices are equal, so by comparing, we can compare the corresponding element and then we can find the unknown variables. Now, addition of matrix. When we can add two matrices and how to add two matrices. For addition of two matrices, the order of the matrix will be same. For example, here these are two matrices, matrix A and matrix B. The order of matrix A is m by n and the order of matrix B also m by n. Aij is the element of matrix A, Bij is the element of matrix B. So for the addition of two matrices, the order of matrices will be same. And then how to add two matrices? For A plus B, A is the matrix C is equal to Cij m by n of the same order such that Cij is equal to Aij plus Bij. These notation means that when we add two matrices, then the corresponding element of matrix A will be added to the corresponding element of matrix B. So for addition, dear students, note that the order of the matrix will be same, and then when we add two matrices, then the corresponding elements will be added. For example, there are two matrices. This is matrix A and this is matrix B. For addition, first of all, check the order of these two matrices. If the order of these two matrices are equal, then we can add these two matrices. The order of matrix A is a 2 by 3. This matrix has 2 rows and 3 columns. This matrix B also has 2 rows and 3 columns. So the order is same, so we can add these two matrices. Now, how to add these two matrices? A plus B is equal to adding the corresponding element. We get the result. For example, the corresponding element in matrix A is 2. Corresponding elements of matrix A 2 is and the matrix B is also the element 2. So A 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. So 3 A 2 minus 4, we get minus 1, and minus 1 plus 3 is equal to 2. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. 0 plus minus 1 is equal to minus 1. And 4 plus 5 is equal to 9. So note that element of the resultant matrix C are obtained by adding each element of matrix A to the corresponding element of matrix B. Similarly, in this example, we note that we cannot add these two matrices. Why we cannot add these two matrices? Because the order of these two matrices are different. This matrix has 3 by 2 order. In this matrix, there are 3 rows and 2 columns. Similarly, in this matrix, there are 2 rows and 3 columns. So we cannot add these two matrices. Similarly, we cannot add a scalar to a matrix. We just add two matrices, and they two matrices can be added when they have the same order. Similarly, the same condition for the subtraction of two matrices. For example, A minus B, subtract the corresponding element of B from minus A, we get the result. 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. 3 minus minus 4 is equal to 7. 1 minus minus 1 minus 3 is equal to minus 4. 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. 0 minus minus 1 is equal to 1. 4 minus minus 4 minus 4. 4 minus 5 is equal to minus 1. Again, I would like to repeat this subtraction. 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. 3 minus minus 4 is equal to 7. 1 minus 1 minus 3 is equal to minus 4. 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. 0 minus minus 1 is equal to plus 1. And 4 minus 5 is equal to minus 1. So note that elements of matrix D, elements of the resultant matrix D are obtained by subtracting each element of matrix B from the corresponding element of matrix A. Now, the properties of matrix addition. Let A, B and C be matrices of the same order and O be the zero matrix of the same order. Then A plus B is equal to B plus A. A plus B is equal to B plus A mean commutative property with respect to addition and matrix always hold. Similarly, another property a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. This property means that associative property with respect to addition in matrix always hold. So a plus into minus a is equal to minus a plus a is equal to o. This property means additio inverse. Each matrix has an additio inverse. Similarly, a plus o is equal to o plus a. This property means additio identity. For example, show that a plus b is equal to b plus a, where a is equal to 1, 2, 3, minus 1, 0, 2, and b is another matrix 2, 4, 0, 3, minus 1, and 1. This is the home task for the student. Now, scalar multiplication. Matrix can be multiplied by a single number called a scalar. In scalar multiplication, multiply every entry in the matrix by that scalar number. For example, minus 2a, for a is equal to 3, minus 2, minus 5, 6, we can find a's. Multiply this minus 2 to the each entry of matrix a, we get minus 2 multiplied 3 is equal to minus 6, minus 2 multiplied minus 2 is equal to 4, minus 2 multiplied minus 5 is equal to 10, and minus 2 multiplied 6 is equal to minus 12. So dear student, note that we cannot add a scalar to a matrix, but we can multiply a scalar to a matrix. Now, properties of scalar multiplication. Let A, B, A and B are two matrices of the same order, and H and K be two scalars. Then K into A plus B, we can write KA plus KB. Similarly, K plus H into A, we can write KA plus HA. And HK into A, we can write H into KA, and similarly we can write K into HA. These are the properties of scalar multiplication. Now, transpose of a matrix. Let A is a matrix of order m by n. The transpose of this matrix A denoted by AT and is defined as A transpose is equal to A11, A21, and so on up to M1. Dear students, in the original matrix, this is the row of the original matrix A11, A12 up to A1n. This is the row of the original matrix, but in the transpose we shift the row into the column. For example, A is a matrix 3 minus 2 minus 5 6. Then find A transpose, shift this row to the column position, we get 3 minus 2, and shift this row to the column position, minus 5, 6. Now, properties of transpose. Let A and B be two m by n matrices and K be a scalar. Then after taking double transpose, we get the original matrix. And KA whole transpose is equal to KA transpose. We cannot apply the transpose on a scalar number. We just only apply the transpose on a matrix. Symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. A square matrix A is symmetric if and only if A transpose is equal to A. In linear algebra, a symmetric matrix will be a square matrix that is equal to its transpose. Formally, because equal matrix have equal dimensions, so only square matrix can be symmetric. For example, this is a matrix is this matrix symmetric, and the matrix, this matrix is symmetric and this matrix is not symmetric. Why this matrix is symmetric? For symmetric matrix, taking the transpose, after taking the transpose, we get this row to we shift this row to this column, then we get 1 3 minus 1 is the row. So if we shift this row to the column, again we get 1 3 minus 1. So if we shift this row to the column, again we get same, this row is in the column position, 3 minus 1 3 minus 3 0. So similarly, if we shift this row to the column position, we get the same entries of that this column, minus 1 0 and 6. So this matrix is a symmetric matrix, and this matrix is not a symmetric matrix. For example, if we shift this row to the column position, the column will be different. Okay, so this matrix is not a symmetric. Now, a skew symmetric matrix. A square matrix is skew symmetric matrix if A transpose is equal to minus A. For example, this is a matrix A. To show that this matrix is skew symmetric, taking the transpose of this matrix, taking the transpose of this matrix, 0, 3, minus 1, to write this row into the column position, 0, 3, minus 1. Now write this row into the column position, we get 3, 0, minus 5, and write this position, write this row in the column position, we get 1, minus 5, 0. And now taking common minus from this matrix, we get 0, 3, minus 1, minus 3, 0, 5, and 1 minus 5 0, which is equal to A. So A transpose is equal to minus A. So this matrix is a skew symmetric. Now, matrix multiplication. This is the most important property of matrix. Let A is a matrix of M by P order, and B is the another matrix of P by N order. Then their product AB is a matrix C of M by N order, where Cij is equal to Ai1 B1j plus Ai2 B2j and so on plus Aip plus BPj. These notation means that the multiplication AB of two matrices A and B will be possible if number of column in matrix B is equal to number of row in matrix A, then multiplication will be possible. And in the resultant matrix, we have same number of rows as the first matrix A and the same number of column is the second matrix B. For example, these are two matrices. The order of this matrix is a 3 by 2 and the order of this matrix is a 2 by 3. This matrix has 3 row and 2 column, and this matrix has 2 row and 3 column. So to multiply these matrices, first of all, to check whether the multiplication is possible, so the multiplication is possible. For the multiplication of AB, we check the number of column will be equal to the number of row, the number of column in matrix A will be equal to the number of row in matrix B. Since this matrix has two column and this matrix has two row, so the number of column in this matrix A is equal to the number of row in this matrix B. So we can multiply these two matrices. Multiplication of these two matrices is possible. Now how to multiply two matrices? For the multiplication, note that fix this row and apply this row to this first column, then this to this second column, and this to third column. For example, for in the multiplication of AB, fix this row and apply to this column. 2 multiplied 2 is equal to 4. 1 multiplied 1 is equal to 1. Now apply this row to this second column. We get 2 multiplied 3 is equal to 6 and 1 multiplied 0 is equal to 0. Now apply this row to this column. 2 multiplied minus 1 is equal to minus 2 and 1 multiplied 4 is equal to 4. Now fix this row and apply this row to each column of matrix B. Fix this row and apply this row to this column. We get 3 multiplied 2 is equal to 6 and 0 multiplied 1 is equal to 0. So applying this row to this column, we get 3 multiplied 3 is equal to 9 and 0 multiplied 0 is equal to 0. Now applying this row on this column, we get 3 multiplied minus 1 is equal to minus 3 and 0 multiplied 4 is equal to 0. Now fix this row. Applying this row on this column, we get minus 1 multiplied 2 is equal to minus 2 and 4 multiplied 1 is equal to 4. Now applying this row on this column, minus 1 multiplied 3 is equal to 3 and minus 1 multiplied 3 is equal to minus 3 and 4 multiplied 0 is equal to 0. Now applying this row on this last column, we get minus 1 multiplied minus 1 is equal to 1 and 4 multiplied 4 is equal 4 multiplied 4 is equal to 16. So the result is 4 plus 1 is equal to 5, 6 plus 0 is equal to 6, minus 2 plus 4 is equal to 2, 6 plus 0 is equal to 6, 9 plus 0 is equal to 9, minus 3 plus 0 is equal to minus 3, and minus 2 plus 4 is equal to 2, minus 3 plus 0 is equal to minus 3, 1 plus 16 is equal to 17. Now to find AB, this is the home task for the student. First of all, check whether BA is possible, multiplication of BA is possible or not. If the multiplication of BA is possible, then we can multiply it. Similarly, here another example, this is a matrix A of order 3 by 2, and this is the matrix B of order 2 by 2. Find the multiplication AB. For the multiplication AB, first of all check the condition that the number of column in matrix A will be equal to the number of row in matrix B, since in this matrix there are 2 row. The number of column in matrix A will be equal to the number of row in matrix B, since in this matrix A there are 2 column, in this matrix B there are 2 row. So the multiplication of these two matrices is possible. Similarly for BA, check the multiplication of BA. For the multiplication of BA, the number of column in matrix B will be equal to the number of row in matrix A. Since B has 2 column and A has 3 row, so BA not possible. In general, the commutative property with respect to multiplication in matrix not hold. Similarly, note that for two matrices A and B, AB whole transpose, we can write B transpose into A transpose. But for n power of matrices, AB whole power n, we can write A power n is equal to, for the whole power n of AB, we can write A power n, B power n. Since A power n denote A multiplied A up to multiplied A up to n factor, A power n mean multiplied A up to n factors. Similarly, this another property, A power n whole power T mean transpose of A power n is equal to A transpose whole power n. Dear students, in this lecture we discuss different operation of matrices in the properties of inshallah in next lecture we will discuss elementary row operations. Thank you for watching this video.